أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear brothers and sisters, inshallah, today we're going to be talking about the sabr in the face of adversity and being content with the divine decree. When we look at the word sabr, this is one of those words that in Quran it has appeared 36 times, just the word sabr by itself. And another variation of the word sabr, meaning sabir and sabirun, it appears 22 times in the Quran. Altogether, if you sum it up, it's about 58 times that you see this word or derivatives of this word coming up in the Quran. Sabr is one of those essential elements of the nafsiyah, or the Islamic disposition. When you look at the sabr, there is no word in English that actually gives you the justice of the meaning that the word sabr in Arabic contains and represents. Sabr includes patience, that's one of the most commonly translated word, perseverance, steadfastness, forbearance, endurance, resistant, and also acceptance of decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah, أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ وَلَمَّا يَأْتِكُمْ مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ مَسَّتْهُمُ الْبَأْسَاءُ وَالضَّرَّاءُ وَزُنْزِلُوا حَتَّى يَقُولَ الرَّسُولُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ مَتَى نَصْرُ اللَّهِ أَلَا إِنَّ نَصْرَ اللَّهِ قَرِيبًا. Or you think that you will enter into paradise without such trials as came to those who passed before you. They were afflicted with severe poverty, ailments, were shaken, that even the messenger and those who believed along with them said, when will the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come? Yes, certainly the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is near. Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 214. In another ayah, Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about 155 and 157. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ السَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ أُولَئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَّبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ. And suddenly we shall test you with something of fear, hunger, loss of wealth, lives and fruits, but give glad tidings to those as-sabreen, the patient ones, the persevere ones, who when disaster strikes them say, indeed we belong to Allah and indeed to Him we will return. Those are the ones upon whom are the blessings from their Lord and mercy. And it is those who are the rightly guided. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ. Khawf is the fear. So fear could be of anything. Fear could be loss of job, that I'm fearing that my livelihood is going to be taken away, or my job, my business. Fear from the oppression from other people. It could be the fear that I might get deported. It could be the fear that my visa get cancelled. It could be fear of anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala actually has in store for us. وَجُوعٍ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ. There could be hunger. It could be that I am fearing that I don't have any food to eat. I'm not going to have any food to eat. وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ, meaning that my wealth, my possessions, my properties could be in decline, could be in jeopardy, it could have a consequence on them if I don't step away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Well, anfusi, meaning that my own life could be life of myself, it could be life of the loved ones that I actually that I love them. Could be my parents, could be my sisters, could be my brothers, could be my wife, could be my sons, could be my daughters, could be my progeny even. So anybody who is fearing, I could have a fear of anybody who losing their life. وَفَّ مَرَاض. Meaning these are the fruits and the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I could have fear for any one of them. I could be, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to test us with all these trials. All these tests are going to come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all these items that are near and dear to our heart. At the same time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that whenever disaster comes to us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that the patient ones are the ones who are the more successful ones. They are the ones who say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilahi raji'un. To Allah we belong and to Allah we return. Right? أُولَٰئِكَ لَهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِنْ رَبِّهُمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ. On those people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving the salawat, the mercy and also the blessings. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُحْتَدُونَ. They are the ones who are the rightly guided ones. In another ayah in Surah Al-Ali Imran, ayah number 186, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَتَبْلُوَنَّ فِي أَمْوَالِكُمْ وَأَنفُسِكُمْ وَلَتَسْمَعُنَّ مِنَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَمِنَ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا أَذًى كَثِيرًا وَإِن تَصْبِرُوا وَتَتَّقُوا وَإِنَّ ذَلِكَ مِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you shall certainly be tried and tested in your wealth and properties and your personal selves, and you shall certainly hear much of the grief from those who receive the scriptures before you, meaning Jews and Christians, and from those who ascribe partners, meaning mushrikeen. But if you persevere patiently and become al-muttaqoon, the one who is always conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's always looking for what is the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for me to follow at that time, the time of the trial, the time of the test. Then become muttaqoon, then verily, that will be determining factor in all affairs. And that is one of the matters of determination. ذَلِكَ مِنْ عَزْمِ الْغُمُورِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Az-Zumar, ayah number 10, إِنَّمَا يُوَفِّ السَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Only those who are patient or remain steadfast shall receive their rewards in full without reckoning. He says in Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 155, وَبَشِّرِ السَّابِرِينَ. But give glad tidings to the patient ones, to the sabirun. In Surah Ali Imran, ayah number 200, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sabiru wa sabiru. O you believe, endure, and be more patient than your adversaries or your enemies. He Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, Walaman sabara wa ghafara inna zalika liman azmil umur. And verily whosoever shows patience and forgives, that would truly be from the things commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 153, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu ista'inu bis sabri was salah, inna allaha ma'as sabirin. O you believe, seek help in patience, in sabr, and as salah, the prayer. Truly Allah is with the as-sabirun, the patient ones, or the steadfast. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that this hadith has been reported by Ahmad, by Mahmud bin Labid, that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal loves a people, he tests them. This is a sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If a test is coming to your way, don't actually see that you're actually being punished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, na'uzu billah. This is a love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing you a love. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jalla loves the people, he tests them. The one who is patient will be granted the patience. The one who shows anguish will be given anguish. What does it mean, patience and the anguish here? Because the tests are coming. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that the tests are coming. And the test is a sign of love from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us. So what does this patience and anguish mean here? This means that if the adversity comes to me, in all the things that are near and dear to my heart, I have to be patient. I have to accept that it's a decree from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the qada of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because as in Imam Fasil, we say that as part of the Imam Mufassil, Al-Qadri Khairi wa Sharihi min Allah Ta'ala. That all the destiny, whether good or bad, is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if good comes, Alhamdulillah, it's good for us, right? But at the same time, if something bad happens, we have to be patient. We have to accept this is the decision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the patience to endure it. He will give us the patience, He will make it easier for us to deal with the situation, deal with the loss, deal with the adversity that's coming our way. But if somebody shows anguish, they actually feel bad. They feel bad for themselves and they say, well, why is this bad thing happening to me? Why is this adversity coming to me? Why am I being tested? What did I do that? That's the anguish. These are the signs of anguish. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show this person more anguish. He will not be feeling peace and content in his heart. That's what the anguish in this hadith means. Then another hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, again reported by Ahmad on the authority of Mus'ab bin Sa'ad. He was asking, who are the people who tested the most? So Rasulullah ﷺ telling us, the prophets come the first. So the prophets among the people are the one who are given them the most number of the test. And then he continues, then the righteous one, and then the second best, and then the next best of the people. A man will be tested on the account of his adherence to his deen. If he is strong in his deen and commitment, he will be more sorely tested. If there is some weakness in his commitment to the deen, the test will be lightened for him. A man will continue to be tested until he walks on the face of the earth with no sin on him. SubhanAllah, this is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he is given these tests as a mercy to us, that by these tests, by enduring these tests, remaining steadfast on those tests, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking away all the sins that we have. Another hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Sa'id, radiyallahu anhu, this hadith is agreed upon. He said that, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the one who tries to have sabr, Allah will grant him sabr. And no one has been given better or larger gift than the sabr. So this is again, this is a good thing for us to have the sabr from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abu Yahya Shu'ayb bin Sanan radiyallahu anhu narrated that the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if he is afflicted by harm, he showed patience, then this would be good for him. This hadith has been reported by a Muslim. And another muttafaq alayhi hadith reported by Anas radiyallahu anhu narrated that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed by a woman who was weeping beside a grave. Rasulullah ﷺ told her to fear Allah and be patient. She said to him, go away, for you have not been afflicted with a calamity like mine. She did not recognize Rasulullah ﷺ. Then she was informed later that this was the Prophet ﷺ. So she went back to the house of Rasulullah ﷺ. There she did not find him any guard. Then she said to him, I did not recognize you. He said, verily the patience is the first stroke of the calamity. What does that mean? Because time always mends people's heart. Right? After given a sufficient length of time, you forget about your loss. Right? So time will always make up or make you forget about the loss that you endured or the adversity that came to you. But patience is really needed at the time of adversity. Something bad happens, say, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَّهِ وَرَاجِعُونَ. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran. That we belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we go back to Him. So adversity is from Allah. The test is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At that time, I have to be patient. And the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reported by Al-Bukhari, on the authority of Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah, now this is hadith al-Qursi, because Allah Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is giving the words from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, associating the words from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, I have nothing to give but paradise as a reward to my believing servant, who if I cause his dear friend to die from this world, remains patient and hopes for Allah's reward. So if somebody that we love, somebody who's near and dear to us, dies, and we remain patient, because this is the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the decision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we remain patient on that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that He will give us the Jannah for that. Another hadith reported by Al-Bukhari, on the authority of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she asked the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the plague. So he informed her, it is a punishment that Allah sends to whom He wills. Talking about the plague. Allah made it a mercy for the believers. There is not a servant who finds himself amidst a plague, but he stays in that land in patience, hoping for Allah's reward, and knowing that nothing can harm him except what Allah has written this. Then this servant will be given a reward like that of a martyr. Now, subhanAllah. Now, he's also telling us this is a communicable disease. Plague is something, it's a communicable disease. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger is giving us the rules for that, how to deal with that situation. Then if you find yourself in a land or a place where there's a plague, there's a communicable disease, then your duty is to stay in that place and hope for the best from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you're not supposed to leave that place because you could be carrying the germs as well. Now we understand why there's the hikmah behind that hukum, but this is the hukum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sent through the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, one of the important aspects is the discontent on the divine decree is haram. This has been declared by the consensus of fuqaha. The fuqaha, they say that by consensus, that whatever the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I have to be in agreement with it, I have to be pleased with it, I have to be okay with it. I cannot show discontent, I cannot show that I don't like that. Even though it's against my interest, it's against what is near and dear to my heart. But I have to be content with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's decree. Showing discontent with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's decree is haram. So for example, if something bad happens or adversity falls, if somebody says that, what have I done to be afflicted this way? What was my sin? Why am I being tested like that? Why am I being punished like this? I don't deserve this. These words and actions are nothing but the rejection of the divine decree. But at the same time, if somebody is afflicted, for example, if somebody is ill, is sick, right? And the person is going to feel the pain. And because of the pain, he may cry. He may have some discomfort. But that's not the showing the discontent from the divine decree. Divine decree is really saying that, okay, well, I did not deserve this ailment. I did not deserve this. We see also in the society, there actually are why me marches going on, for example, for breast cancer, right? We heard that, right? They actually have a procession going on and actually awareness created among the people among a disease like breast cancer or any other diseases. So why me? This is showing the discontent to the divine decree. Because if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided for you to have a type of cancer, a type of ailment, you will get it. You should not ask why me, but you should be saying this is the amal of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the decision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's another hadith reported by Mahmud bin Labid. When Allah loves the people, He tests them. The one who is patient will be granted the patience. The one who shows anguish will be given anguish. There's another... So the question comes in, if I am given a adversity by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the decision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So why would He be giving me the reward or the punishment? It is because if I accept that wholeheartedly, because this is the amr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the decision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if I accept that, but if I reject that, so I don't like this, or start complaining to people. See what happened to me. See? I'll go and talk to the people and bring people's attention to the calamity that befell on you. This is something that you're rejecting the, or you're complaining to the people. This is where this is not allowed. And if somebody who shows anguish like this way, the person will persist anguish. And you will also see that some people fall into depression. Some people even lose their mind because they are not able to reconcile the loss that they had. And this is because they are not accepting the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if I accept the decree, if I accept the loss, I accept the decree of the adversity, and this is the decision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward me, and also ward off my sins from me. Essentially, this decree is nothing but a kafara, or expiation from my sin, to remove all the mistakes I have done. For example, another hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the hadith narrated by Abdullah, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this is a muttafiq alayh hadith, that no Muslim is afflicted with any harm, but that Allah will remove his sins as the leaves of the tree fall down. Like we see in the fall, the tree leaves are actually falling down. Just like that, when the leaves are leaving the tree, the sins of the person would actually leave the person by accepting the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And another hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the authority of Aisha radiallahu anha, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no calamity befalls a Muslim, but that Allah expiates some of his sins because of it, even though it was a prick he receives from a thorn. Just think about it. This is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even a small prick, a small discomfort that we receive, we should say Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah kulli hal. Right? That we should be saying Alhamdulillah in any condition that we find ourselves in. Because even if the prick is actually giving us a discomfort, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is actually forgiving our sins because of that. And the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reported by Abu Huraira and Abu Sa'id, that no fatigue or disease, nor sorrow, nor sadness, nor hurt, nor distress befalls a Muslim, even if it were a prick he receives from a thorn, but Allah expiates some of his sins for that. So reward is in accepting the divine decree, having patience, gratitude, not complaining to anybody except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's okay to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. It's okay to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he lightens the load for us, that he forgives our sins, that he removes the adversity from us, removes the test from us, and makes us successful in the test that he has put ourselves in, right? But at the same time, it's not allowed for us to be complaining to the people. That's the key aspect right there. There's another hadith of Al-Bukhari on the authority of Abu Hurairah radhiyallahu anhu, who said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no calamity, how small it is, befalls a Muslim in this world, and he hopes patiently for the reward, except that his sons will be wiped out on the Day of Judgment. Now, we talked about patience and sabr. Sometimes people take that patience, the word sabr, in a wrong way. Because this sometimes confuses people. When we see that there is a munkar, there is an evil in our society, we see that evil is in society, and actually people are doing some wrong things in front of us. Some people say to have sabr on it. Sabr is not to be patient when we see the evil in front of us. Sabr is not when we see that our sanctities are getting violated. The hudud of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are suspended. The commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are getting abandoned. We are not supposed to have sabr on that. We need to take a stand on these things. These are the very things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to take a stand. Meaning that we have to do amr al ma'ruf wa nahi al munkar. We have to forbid the evil. We need to say to the people that whatever is wrong has to be stopped. So we need to have the strength, We need to find among ourselves the strength to speak the truth, even in the time of adversity. We need to do what will make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with us. This is the patience, that this is the right patience. This is not the patience that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands are being violated and we feel content in our heart. We keep quiet. We cocoon ourselves into a corner. We disassociate ourselves from the society. So, well, the society is doing bad, I'm not going to actually concern myself by telling them not to do the bad things. Because if I tell them, they're going to come after me. So there's going to be adversity for me. That's at that time when people are telling you, people are opposing you, when you're saying the haq, this is where you have to persevere. You have to endure. You have to actually remain steadfast on enjoining the good and forbidding the evil. This is where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Zumar, ayah number 10, إِنَّمَا يُوَفِّي السَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. So this is the sabr Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, that only those who are patient, who persevere, who remain steadfast in that situation, shall receive the reward in full, without reckoning. And this is the type that we just talked about, disassociating yourself from the society, cocooning yourself at the time of adversity, when you're trying to forbid the evil. This is the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger used to actually have a dua, أعوذ بالله من العجز والكسل والجبن والبخل والهم والحزن وغلبة الدين وقهر الرجال. Translation: O Allah, I seek refuge in you from worry and grief, from helplessness and laziness, from cowardice and stinginess, and from overpowering of debt and from the oppression of men. So this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger used to ask: cowardice. If I am removing myself from the society, from not enjoining the good and forbidding the evil, because of the test that's coming to my way, because of the oppression I may be feeling, or because of the hardship that I'm facing, because of that, that is the thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messengers asked was for cowardice, laziness, and helplessness. Then we should seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help, so that we find the strength from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enjoin the good and forbid the evil. If the hardship is coming our way in doing this, we have to bear the hardship. This is really the sabr that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about. In another ayah, in Surah Yusuf, ayah number 90, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّهُ مَنْ يَتَّقِي وَيَصْبِرْ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيعُ أَجْرَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Verily, he who fears Allah with obedience to him and is patient, then surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes not the reward of the muhsineen to be lost. It is really the patience of affliction and the divine decree that leads one to be steadfast and firm and not to be shaken. It leads a person to hold on to the Quran, to the Sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not to neglect it under the pretext of patience. It brings a servant closer to his Lord and not distances him from him. In another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Surah Al-Anbiya, ayah number 87, فَنَادِي فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. But he cried through the darkness, saying, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ, none has a right to be worshipped but you, O Allah. Glorified and exalted are you above all the evil they associate with you. Truly I have been of the wrongdoers. It's the kind of the patience which strengthens the resolve, brings the path to the Jannah closer. It is the patience of Bilal, the Khabab, and the family of Yasir. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he passed by Ali Yasir while they were getting persecuted by the Kuffar and Mushrikeen, what does he say? Sabr ya Ali Yasir, إِنَّ مَوْعِدِكُمَ الْجَنَّةِ. Have patience, O family of Yasir, for indeed your abode is Jannah. This is the patience that even though they're getting persecuted, they're getting tortured physically, mentally, one of the family members getting killed in front of the other, they are not staying away from saying the haq. They are not backing away from Islam. That's the patience that we need. That's the patient Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking us to help. This is the patience of the Khubab and Zayd. By Allah, I would not want to be safe and secure among my family even when a thorn hurts the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were asking him, would you wish that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would have been in place of you getting tortured? What was his response? That I don't want to be secure while even a thorn hurts the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that's the patience, that's the steadfastness, that's the resolve that we need. It is the patience of those who restrain the hands of the tyrant without fearing for any fearing anything for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nay, by Allah, you have to enjoin the good for good and the forbid the wrong, and restrain the hands of the tyrant, and to force him on the truth, and to confine him to the truth. Otherwise, Allah will be about to strike the hearts of some of you against others. Then he will curse you as he cursed the children of Israel. It's really the patience of the distinguished companions, the Haba of Rizwan Allah alayhim ajma'in, who said, the patience of Allah, the Shafi'a, and those who boycotted the ship, Abdul Muttalib, the migrants to Abyssinia, the Habasha, and those who punished for no reason other than saying, our Lord is Rabb, Allahu Rabbana. It is the patience of the Muhajirin and Ansar in the struggle against the Mushrikeen, the Persians and the Romans. It is the patience of those who take prisoners from the troops of Abdullah bin Abu Huzaifa. It is the patience of the believing and the honest Mujahideen. It is the patience of those who enjoin the good and forbids the evil and does not become weak due to the hardships in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the patience of those who confirms the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he says in Surah Al-Imran, Ayah 186, you certainly shall be tried and tested in your wealth and properties and your personal selves, and you shall certainly hear much that will grieve you from those who receive the scriptures before you, that is Jews and Christians, and from those who ascribe partners to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is Mushrikeen. But if you persevere patiently and become al-muttaqoon, the pious, then verily that will be a determining factor in all affairs, and that is from the great matters. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Muhammad, ayah number 31, and surely we shall try you till we test those who strive hard for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the patient ones, and we shall test you, your facts. There is a one who is a liar and one who is a truthful, meaning that who is really saying that they believe, then they would be tested. And let's see who's going to be remain steadfast during the test. And certainly we shall test you. And there's another ayah in the Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah 155, 157. Certainly we shall test you with something of fear, the hunger, loss of wealth, lives and fruits. But give glad tidings of sabirun, who when afflicted with calamity say, truly to Allah we belong, truly to Him we shall return. They are those on whom are salawat, the blessings from their Lord, and receive His mercy. It is they who are the guided ones. So in conclusion, let's remind ourselves from some of the ayahs of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Surah Al-Imran, ayah number 200, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, amanu spiru wa sabiru wa rabidu wa attaqullaha la'allakum tuflihun. O you believe, persevere and endure, and remain stationed and fear Allah that you may be successful. In Surah Al-A'raf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in ayah 126, وَمَا تَنْقِمُ مِنَّا إِلَّا أَنْ آمَنَّ بِآيَاتِ رَبَّنَا لَمَّا جَاعَتْنَا رَبَّنَا أَفْرِقْ عَلَيْنَا صَبْرٌ وَتَوَفَّنَا مِنْ مُسْلِمِينَ. And you take vengeance on us because we believed in ayahs of our Lord, and then when they reach us, O Lord, pour out on us patience or sabr and cause us to die as Muslimin. Now this is a very key aspect. This is one of the dua, Rabbana afriq alayna sabran wa tawaffana Muslimin. This is one of the dua that we should be asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always. That is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who can give us the patience. to remain steadfast, to persevere. So we should always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, say, رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ عَلَيْنَا صَبْرًا, that He pour on to us the patience and the sabr. And one of the ayahs, one of the surah of Al-Asr, that actually is a very one of the short surah in the Quran, is a very good reminder for all of us about the sabr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing by the time. Verily man is in loss. Except those, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, except those who believe, عَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, do good deeds, righteous deeds, وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ and وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. And who actually enjoin others to say the haqq and of the patience, of the sabr. With that, I would like to close that. وَأَخَذَ مَعَنَا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ